Welcome to cooking. Today we are doing a favorite with a twist. We are doing mac and cheese with broccoli and cauliflower. Something that tastes great and it gets in there all of those great antioxidants that we have in our sulfur containing vegetables, and you don't even really know they're there. Okay, so after washing your hands, let's read through the ingredients. We have 2 cups of chopped cauliflower. Now, we have already cooked this because it was, and at your house, if it was left over the night before, you could prep this after one supper for prepping this meal the next day. So you already can have this ready. So we don't even have to boil, or we would never boil vegetables in this area, would we? But we would have to steam this typically, but today, already cooked. So we've got 2 cups of that. We have 3 cups of elbow macaroni. We put in this whole box, which is great, right? We always aim to cook it once, eat it multiple times. So we've already got that cooked as well. And then we have our frying pan out here with our canola oil, or today we have grapeseed oil and some flour. We're gonna make what we call a roux. We'll talk more about that. We have milk, our cauliflower, we have cheese already grated, we have our cream cheese, and then our seasonings, salt, pepper, paprika, and some breadcrumbs for on top. So let's talk directions. How do we do this? Well, we've preheated the oven to 350 because this is going to be a baked item. Now, if you're going to make this and freeze it, you don't need to bake it first. You would just freeze it when you take it out of the freezer. No, cook it when you take it out of the freezer later. So normally step number one is to cook our vegetables. We've already got them cooked. And then to puree them, we're not gonna puree them today. We're just gonna leave them because they're finely diced. Thank you to Marianne. The second step is to bring a large pot of water to a boil and add the macaroni, and we've already done that as well. So these are 2 things that can be done even the day before with the macaroni, or a meal before and then cooled. While the macaroni is cooking, step number 3, coat a large saucepan with the spray. Actually, we're gonna change that because you don't need to coat a saucepan with spray if you're adding oil. So we're just gonna add the oil and we're gonna put in the flour. Now the goal with that is that when the oil heats up and it dissolves the flour, it thickens into a paste. That's called a roux en français. So a roux is the basis of a white sauce, and that's what we're making today with the cheese sauce. So we're making a roux, we're gonna add the cheese to it, and that's gonna be the thickener. So in the box of mac and cheese, that's your package of cheese, only we're using real food. All right, so we're gonna cook it until it's thickened but not browned, because browning is when the flour, the natural sugar that's in the flour, is going to caramelize. But we don't want that caramelization in this step or at all in this recipe, because it'll change just the flavor of it. So we're just going to thicken it, take it off before it's browned. Then we're going to slowly add in the milk, and if you add it all together, it might get clumpy. So we're just going to put it in and just stir it quickly as it were throwing it in. And then we're going to add our cauliflower, our cheeses together, and our spices. Stir it all together, and then we're going to add our macaroni at the end. Now at this point, everything's going to be cooked. So if you are, you know, kind of running behind, and or you don't want to turn your oven on for the day and it's the summertime, there is no reason why you have to actually throw this in the oven after to crisp up the top. That's just going to look pretty, right? So you can actually just eat it after you throw it all in the pot and mix it all together with the macaroni. So feel free. Number 6, as optional, to put into a baking sheet, put the breadcrumbs on the top. You can even throw a little bit more cheese if your children like cheese, and then you can brown up the top. But that part is definitely optional. So let's get started. So we've got our broccoli and cauliflower cooked. We've got this cooked. So now we just have to go to the stovetop and we're gonna make our roux. All right, we've got our element on. We're gonna add our oil in. So 2 tablespoons of grapeseed oil today. There we go. And then we add in 1 tablespoon of flour. There we go. So let's You can see that it's nice and warm. My pan is a little uneven, so we have to get it where it's... So let's let that sit for a moment. I think it's almost there. Let's measure out our milk. So again, milk is a liquid. We need a liquid measuring cup. So our one cup is right there. So you put it on something flat and you bend down to eye level. And there we go. One cup of milk. Perfect, so let's add this in and we'll whisk it as we go. There. Now I'm gonna stop for a minute. That was got quite a bit thicker in the middle, so that was good to see. So cold milk adding to a hot pan, you get that lovely sound. Now we gotta bring this back up to temperature. You can see in the corners there, it's got some thickening action going on. Now sometimes we double the amount of oil and flour. If you find it's not cheesy enough, then you might want to do that as well. So we're gonna leave that and let that cook for just, it says 3 to 4 minutes. Might turn that up a little bit just because my element is not the hottest. And when your pan is not flat, then it's not going to dissipate the heat evenly. So you have to find out where the hot spot is on your pan to keep everything from burning. There, I do feel that it's starting to thicken up a little bit more with that addition of the milk. We thicken it and then we thin it again with milk and we expect it to thicken back up again. Such demands we have on food textures. I'll turn it down a little bit just so it doesn't stick as we get going. So we'll add in our cauliflower, heat it back up again. Now you can also just put in big chunks of cauliflower and broccoli if you'd like, or zucchini or onions or peppers. Whatever you would like. Sometimes it's easier instead of having multiple things on your plate for a meal just to throw everything and have a casserole, right? So that's kind of what we're doing. We're casseroling it up today. I'm gonna warm this up and we can add our cheese. Okay. So that's our 3 cups of cheddar. Now I do just want to show you what the package looked like because Marianne was able to find an old cheddar that was light in fat. Thank you. So we want the old because that means that it's going to be more flavorful. But see right there, the percentage M period F period. So that's milk fat. Usually cheese is around 32-35%. So this as a light is 40% less fat, and that's less, it's always less than 20%. So this is a low fat cheese, but because it's an old cheese, the flavor is still gonna be there. So that is fantastic. We're also going to add in our cream cheese. Now, something to think about is I've been noticing that a lot of the regular cream cheeses now have milk as a first ingredient, but I'm finding that the ones that are light cream cheeses, either a name brand or a no-name brand, the ingredients start with modified milk. So I much prefer people to get the regular cream cheese and to have real ingredients versus something that's modified milk. Now it's interesting, right? Because we buy milk that's low fat 1%, 2%, or skim. And there's not much difference between the regular milk and the HOMO milk. HOMO milk is only 3.25%. That comes straight out of a cow. So in order to make cheese, the milk has to sit with bacteria, but the liquid is taken off of it, and the solid part is what's left, and that's the cheese. And so that's why cheese is so high in fat, 35%. You've got to start with a lot of milk to get a brick of cheese, because we're moving from a 3.25% product of fat to a 35% product of fat. So it definitely takes a lot of milk to get your cheese. So if you can get something that's lower in fat but still has the flavor, then I am all for that. All right, so we've got our cheese in. Our cream cheese is mostly melted here. You can see how thick it is. It smells delightful. And you have to keep stirring because this cheese, there's, well, not necessarily the cheese, but in the milk, there's some natural sugar in there, so it will stick for sure. So as that's finishing warming up, let's add in our spices. So we've got half a teaspoon of salt. So again, lovely measuring method on the salt, isn't it? Pour this into our hand, fill up our half of a teaspoon. Thank you, and find a garbage. Next, we have a quarter teaspoon of pepper. Wonderful. So if you love pepper, especially freshly ground pepper, you can definitely add more of that. And then we've got a quarter teaspoon of paprika. So paprika doesn't have a flavor per se, but it's definitely going to help with the color. So if your kids like the color of boxed mac and cheese, add more paprika. Okay, perfect. Thank you, Marianne. So let's stir this around. And I'm not sure how difficult you guys know it is, but Rebecca's behind the camera, sweating buckets, holding it steady. So thank you, Rebecca, for all of your hard work. Awesome. So now we've got all of our spices, we've got all of our vegetables, we got all of our cheese melted, and now what's left is just to add the macaroni. So at this point, everything is warm except for the macaroni. So if you want to eat it without baking it, then you're just gonna have to leave it in the pan a little bit longer. And remember, this is the whole box. I should show you the box, actually. So this is our whole grain wheat, means that it used all the fiber and all the vitamins and minerals that are with that fiber, thus the brown color, thus healthier for us. So you might want to start with just adding half so that you can see how cheesy, well, I added about two-thirds. We'll see how cheesy it looks. You know what I'm going to do? I'm going to add a little bit more milk because then it'll thin it a little bit and we can spread it around a little bit easier. There we go. So I'm very sorry to say you can't smell it, but from this side of the camera, it definitely smells delicious. So it depends how cheesy you'd like it. I'm thinking that's pretty good, actually. Yeah, now we have a little bit of macaroni already cooked, and we could make some cold macaroni salad with it. You could turn it into spaghetti for lunch. Remember, cook it once, eat it multiple times. Awesome, we're gonna turn the element off, and then we're going to put it into our baking pans and then into the oven. So maybe, let's see, it might go into one pan. I wasn't really sure. There we go. Remember, we work so hard, we want to get it everything out of there. That looks delightful. Now it is already nice and hot, so feel free to go ahead and eat this just as it is. We're gonna add some breadcrumbs, stick it in the oven. You could even just add some breadcrumbs, stick it in the oven on broil. It doesn't need any more heating up. So in a class setting, all of these steps would have been done at different times, and we found that it was quite a bit cooler when it went into the oven. But now we just need to stick it on broil to brown up that the crumbs on the top. So, recipe calls for half of a cup of breadcrumbs. Now, there's a couple of different kinds. This is just a plain breadcrumb. This is a panko, which is a Japanese-style breadcrumb. These breadcrumbs have been deep-fried already. That's why they're crunchier. So, you can choose whatever you'd like. We're just going to sprinkle them on top. Perfect. There we go. So we're going to put that in the oven, and I think we're just going to put it on broil just so that we can brown up the crumbs on top, and we'll see you back in 2 minutes.
Okay, perfect. We pulled it out of the oven after 2 minutes on broil. It's nicely browned. The spot could have used a little bit more, but oh well.
So as a reminder, this is mac and cheese. So cheese is the protein part and the macaroni is the carbohydrate part. We do have some vegetables in here, but to make this a complete meal, you're gonna wanna add in some more veggies on the side, a salad or some raw ones. And then this makes up your other side. So there you are, homemade mac and cheese with broccoli and cauliflower.